What's that time again?
We're gonna go see about some whales.
We're gonna go see about some whales at Ojo de Liebre, which is just south of Guerrero Negro. It's one of the more popular places to go because it's pretty easily accessible. You could actually make, it would be probably a 2-day trip from the US, but you can get here first if you wanted to see gray whales from the US, and it's the last stop if you're like us, headed from the southern part of the peninsula. But they're very accessible. Last we heard, there were like 400 whales out here.
Yeah, it's a lot.
And they pile up in the high part of the season. It said there can be thousands of them. So we're gonna go out and look for maybe one. You'd be happy with one whale?
More, I want more than one.
She's so greedy, she's so whale greedy. So we'll show you how it's done. You pretty much, we camped here last night and we're gonna walk down to the pier. And we're told that we can just pay on the spot and hop on a panga, and it should be around $50. So we'll go check that out and see how it works.
Yep.
Go see about some whales.
Yes, let's go. Wow, 3 whales at a time. Wow, so gestation is 12 months. That means while they're here giving birth, they're gonna mate again.
To get on the boat, you have to go to the restaurant and buy a ticket, which we did. One of the captains was nice enough to tell us. And then we sat around for about an hour waiting for more people, and it looks like we may get our own private boat, which would be spectacular.
Yeah.
Not that they limit it to 6 people, so it's not like we would have a bunch of people on the boat, but if it's just us, that's pretty amazing.
Yeah. Hi, dude.
It's low tide right now, but when the tide comes in, you can come down the dock and you actually get to feed the whales. They give you little pieces of chicken and you just hold it out and the whales jump up and take it out of your hand.
No.
What?
Don't believe him. He's a liar.
Oh, that's what they do with crocodiles in the Everglades. I got the two confused. I don't know how that happened.
We got our own boat.
Well, I was mistaken. The tides come in here on the dock, and there's no whales to feed. So if you're coming here to feed the whales, probably not going to happen. Sorry.
Seeing the gray whales here in Ojo de Liebre is a must-do.
Awesome. That absolutely was, awesome.
Yep, incredible.
There are so many whales out there constantly spouting, breaching, flapping their flukes. You'd look one way and then you'd hear another one over there, and you'd look that way.
You didn't know which way to look.
Yeah, they're everywhere.
And the adults would come up to the boat and go under and like scratch their backs on the bottom.
Again, being environmentally and wildlife conscious, we were kind of concerned about how close we would get to the whales. How are these captains? We just go motor around into this area where there are whales all around, and then the whales would come to you.
Yeah, they come up to the boat.
So, I don't know the science. We can't get into the brains of whales, but there's definitely, in my opinion now, I'm convinced that the whales like interacting with humans. They would come up and they would roll over and they would do the little spying and just really cool.
They'd look at you.
Yeah.
Their eyes.
By the way, Ojo de Liebre, you know what that means?
I know it means eye something.
Eye of the tiger.
No, it doesn't.
It's the... I'm not going to sing that because I don't want YouTube to slap us with a copyright infringement. Ow. Do you know what Ojo de Liebre means?
I feel like I knew, but I forgot.
Yeah. We didn't do our research before we got out here, and there's no cell service here. In case you're wondering, there's no cell service out here. You drive for about 15 miles through the salt flats, just south of Guerrero Negro, which reminds me, we're headed to Guerrero Negro now. We're going to stop for some fish tacos, so we think. We've heard that they're the best fish tacos in all of Baja.
Yeah, we'll find out.
So we've been told, but we're going to stop there for gas, and we got a long day of driving ahead of us. At least 27 hours worth of driving today.
27 hours?
There's not 27 hours in the day, babe. But we do have, I think it's about 7 hours to get to San Felipe. And that is our goal. We are sadly leaving Baja. So our goal is to get to San Felipe tonight, spend the night at Victor's RV park, and then wheels up in the morning and cross the border and make our way to cold Arizona. But this was a spectacular way to end our time in Baja.
Glad the rain held off.
Yeah, it was raining last night.
And we were able to do it.
It's going
to
rain again today, but for this morning, spectacular. Yeah, it was perfect. And the private boat.
Yeah.
We got our own boat. That was great.
Yeah, it was cool.
Yeah, I didn't have to push anybody overboard to see the whales. On that note, we definitely would say this is a great spot to see the whales. Mm-hmm. There's four places to see the whales in Baja before they start their migration. The very southern part of the peninsula, you've got Magdalena Bay and San Carlos. And then there's Adolfo Lopez Mateo, which is where we stopped and we saw him for the first time. Mm-hmm. And then there's Laguna San Ignacio, about an hour outside of San Ignacio. And then there is Ojo de Liebre, which is the northernmost part. Before the whales will exit this bay here, and they'll go out in the Pacific, and they will have a party there. All the whales from all the bays get together, have a big party, and then they migrate north up to Alaska to feed. So the cool thing now is none of those whales are eating. None of them have been eating. Only the babies will be nursing.
Yeah.
But they're just hanging out, waiting for the water to get warm enough to head back north to Alaska. Oh, and they're mating. Yeah, how could I forget that? Anyway, we're going to hit the road. We got a lot of driving to do. Yep. So we'll see you for fish tacos in Guerrero Negro. We'll be right back. tacos at a food truck.
Somewhere in the middle, try to find myself again. But life is one big riddle of the future and what's been. Guess it's the way it goes, and I will never know why you let me go. Look to the left, look to the right, nothing can stop me in the night, like I am leaving all the bad stuff. And trying to remain so strong, I know it's good if I'm on. I got it, I gotta go, go, go. Running to better times, go, go, go. From my emotions, I'll go, go, go. Running to better times, to better times, to better times. To better times, to better times. Remember I was laughing in all the photos that you took. But now it looks like acting, like we were fiction in a book. Guess it's the way it goes, and I will never know why you let me go. We just turned on to the 5.
Yes!
And the last time we were here, it was not all the way paved. It was awful.
We were on a side road that took us through the mountains. Dirt road. All yep. kinds of crazy.
Watch our video for that. Right here. If you'd like to see that. But now we've heard that the entire Highway 5 is totally paved. Except for a couple of bridge crossings. So we're excited.
This is going to be amazing.
Brand new. Brand new highway.
Brand new highway in Mexico. This is awesome.
And it's wide, unlike the one.
It's got a shoulder so far.
It does. It has a shoulder.
Let's see how long that lasts.
Yeah. Look to the left, look to the right. Nothing can stop me in the night, like I am leaving all the bad stuff. And trying to remain so strong. I know it's good if I'm alone. I got it. I got it.
After about 8 hours of being in the truck, we made it to San Felipe. We're camped at Victor's, which is our favorite place to camp here in San Felipe, and we're right on the water. There's not much of a sunset, so the whales were the highlight of today, and saw some pretty spectacular scenery driving. But we are one day away now from crossing the border back into the United States, and we'll spend a couple days in Arizona before making our long trek toward Florida. But for now, we are set up and we will enjoy our time here tonight in San Felipe. Then we'll get up in the morning and make our way to the border.